Here come the newlyweds. Yes, it's the newlywed game. And now let's meet our newlywed couples for today. Couple number one. The cake she baked for their second month anniversary was so rickety, it had to be held together with toothpicks. Married just 18 weeks, Larry and Candy Thomas. Couple number two, while on their honeymoon, these newlyweds became good friends with a couple whose car ran into the back of theirs. Married just 10 months ago, Eldon and Chris Hort. Couple number three, these newlyweds don't believe in ghosts or ghost towns, since they once spent 2 days trying to find one. Married just 5 months, John and Peggy Tidwell. Couple number four, she complains that when they go to a restaurant, he orders a chicken dinner by imitating the chicken. Married just 8 months ago, Rick and Sharon Dubinsky. Those are our couples for today. And here's your host, now the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubank.
Well, thank you and welcome to the Newlywed Game. You know, they say that little things mean a lot. Here on the Newlywed Game, I couldn't be truer, because it's the little things our couples remember that may win them a grand prize. You'll see what I mean right after this one.
Roasting pans used to be a big cleanup problem. But today, roasting pans come with Teflon. So easy to clean, even the messiest mess doesn't stick. Teflon. So you can use the time after a great meal for something other than cleanup.
Thank you. Okay, sweetie, let's see your stirring stroke.
Why is this light? I skipped the stirring.
Yeah? Then paint some and drip a little. I want to see how you wipe up the drips.
But I use Lucite. It doesn't make a drippy mess. I skip wiping.
Oh, yeah? Well, let's see you clean up.
But I use Lucite. All I need is soap and water. I skip that mess. Any more questions?
Just one. Will you marry me?
All right, gentlemen, here we go. It's the Newlywed Game. As you know, your wives have been secluded off stage and cannot hear your answers. I'm going to ask you some questions and want each of you to answer them as you predict your wife will. Now, if your prediction matches your wife's answer, you'll be awarded 5 points. And the one couple with the most points will win an exciting grand prize selected especially for them. So remember, gentlemen, answer these questions as you predict your wives will. And here's question number one. Gentlemen, what thing belonging to the two of you will your wife say her mother would love to get her hands on? Rick?
Well, I don't know. Her mother collects clocks. And when she came to visit us the last time, she brought us a beautiful 400-day clock, and I think she'd kind of
like to get her hands on your 400-day clock. John?
I'd say our carpeting, because my mother-in-law's carpeting isn't too good.
Your carpeting?
Ours is real good.
Eldon?
Well, my mother-in-law's not going to like this, but I'll say me.
You. No, I can't accept it. What thing?
Okay, thing. I would say a small lantern that we recently got.
A lantern you recently purchased. Larry?
Well, there's not much that she would want, but if anything, it'd be her car.
It'd be something belonging to the two of you.
I see. Okay, then.
Otherwise, is the car belonging to you and your wife?
Well, we have two cars, but I would say hers.
All right, as long as it belongs
right.
Basically to the two of you as a couple, all right? Next question, gentlemen. How will your wife say you would complete the sentence? My wife doesn't know this. But the girls that really appeal to me are what, John?
My wife doesn't know it.
Girls that really appeal to me are?
Are real classy.
Real classy. Eldon?
Something she doesn't know. Well, fairly short.
Fairly short. Larry?
I would have to say blonde.
Blonde.
She's a brunette and she's going to kill me.
Rick?
I've always dated blondes, so it would have to be blondes, and thank God my wife is blonde.
Blonde, all right. Here's the last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, if your wife were a dog, what breed will she say she'd be? Eldon?
Ooh, if she was a dog. German Shepherd.
German Shepherd, Larry?
It would have to be a big dog, so I'd have to say St. Bernard.
St. Bernard, Rick.
I don't really like dogs, but... Cocker Spaniel. That's
Cocker
the only
Spaniel,
kind of dog I guess.
John?
Well, it has to be a Samoan, because I have a Samoan dog, and it's dumb, and my wife's dumb, and just like it is. It's got to be a Samoan.
What kind of a dog would it be?
A Samoan.
Oh, it's Samoan.
Yeah,
I thought you were the small one. All right.
No, Samoan.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for your answers. We'll be right back to reunite our newlyweds, and we'll see how well the husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Ever since Eve, women have faced the problem of preventing a shortage of iron. A leading medical journal reports that many healthy young women have little or no iron reserves. You see, some women even risk becoming anemic and tired. Take just one FemIron tablet every day. FemIron gives you iron, all iron, to maintain the supply you need to prevent iron shortage. So today, get FemIron, the very, very feminine iron tablet.
Did that pretty dress fit you last week, but not this week? Try new ProSlim 7-Day Reducing to help you lose those extra pounds. You get a diet plan, and instead of fattening between meal nibbling, you enjoy ProSlim high-protein wafers. In clinical tests, doctors report pounds lost in 7 days with ProSlim. Additional menus help maintain weight loss. Eat ProSlim high-protein wafers instead of fattening snacks. Try ProSlim 7-Day Reducing. It really helps you reduce.
The shield. That's the Glowcoat heel mark shield. It shields against Tommy's black heel marks. All of them? Just about. Terrific.
Now, I'll wax hard enough to form a heel mark shield. Hard gloss Glowcoat. So hard it takes a pounding and keeps on shining.
Hey, wait! I gotta get a shield for my floor.
It shields against black heel marks. Hard gloss Glowcoat.
Week after week after week, a woman polishes her furniture, so that in a few months' time, she's put on this much polish and ends up polishing the polish instead of the furniture. But not so with new self-cleaning Favor. Favor cuts through old polish and dirt. Now, if Favor can clean up this mess, it'll take care of any buildup problem you have and give you a fresh wax shine each time you dust. So clear up your buildup problems. Try new Favor with lemon wax.
Okay, gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in your laps. Every time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you'll be given 5 points. The one couple with the most points at the end of the show will win a grand prize selected especially for them. Here's question number one, and their 5-pointers. Girls, what thing belonging to the two of you would your mother love to get her hands on? Candy?
I know. My 10-speed osterizer.
Your 10-speed osterizer, she'd love to get her hands on that. Larry said she'd love to get her hands on your car.
Your
mine?
Car. Yeah.
She doesn't want mine.
She's got a rattle trap for a car.
She doesn't want mine. It doesn't run half the time.
Well.
Chris?
I have to go with him car.
Car?
His car.
All right. Ellen predicted you would say she'd love to get her hands on your lantern.
My what?
You should have heard my first answer.
Your lantern.
My what?
What do you
your
think?
Lantern. That little lantern that you have in your bedroom.
No. Peggy?
Our pool, I think.
Your pool? Fine. John said you'd love to get her hands on your carpet.
No,
the what?
The carpet. You know how bad your mom's carpet is.
What?
A piece of rag.
Bought at the same time mine.
Well, ours is, more classier. Still it is.
Well, I think our dining room set could...
Dining room set?
Oh, no.
See, Rick said you'd love to get her hands on your 400-day clock.
The clock?
Well, she collects clocks. She bought our dining room set.
Yeah, but I think she'd like the clock back.
Next question for 5 points. Girls, how did your husband complete this sentence? My wife doesn't know this, but the girls that really appeal to me are what, Chris?
Dark-haired girls. He works with.
Dark-haired girls. All right. Elvin says are fairly short.
Short?
Yes, of course. Blonde. You know I like blondes.
No, he likes dark-haired girls.
I like short girls.
Tall. No, he likes.
He said he likes short girls.
He doesn't know.
Wait a minute.
Short girls.
You like short ones or not, Elvin?
Short girls.
Short girls.
Sure.
I know.
Okay. Built better than I am.
Okay, are built better than my wife. John Fisher, you would say are really classy.
Yeah, classy. A lot of bread.
Sure?
I say blondes because I'm a blonde.
Are blondes. Blondes are right. Okay, and you get the point. Candy, my wife doesn't know this, but the girls that really appeal to me are what?
Blonde.
He said, are blonde.
Yeah, right. I'll like blonde forever, even if I can't be one.
Here's the last of our 5-point questions. Girls, if you were a dog, what breed would you be? Peggy?
A greyhound, I guess.
A greyhound. A greyhound.
A greyhound. What's wrong with that Samoan?
Well, the greyhound is fast.
You're just as dumb as that Samoan. Just what I told him. You're dumb, too. You are. She is.
Not.
Hmm. Sure.
Would you repeat that again?
Shirley, if you were a dog, what breed would you be?
Well, I like this dog. I can't pronounce it. I think it's a Chasso Apso. Well, we
sounds like a South American dance to me.
It's called a Chasso
Apso. He says a Cocker Spaniel.
She's right, though. If we ever got a dog, that's the dog we'd get.
What kind?
The Chasso Apso.
It's real cute and curly.
The Cocker?
No, the other one.
Oh. Candy?
He'd better say a German Shepherd.
He said you'd be something big, like a St. Bernard.
St. Bernard?
They're big. Well, I don't like them. They eat too much. We can't have one.
You ever seen the back legs on a...
No.
Well, what kind of dog did I say?
St. Bernard. St. Bernard. A Chasso Apso.
You know, the big hip.
Thank you.
Are you trying to insinuate something?
You fit. You both have big hips.
Pardon?
She does. She has big hips.
Don't compare me to a dog.
Well, that's the only one that comes close to it.
Could say a Cocker Spaniel.
No, or a Chasso Apso.
Or a Chasso Apso.
No,
right.
We don't want to say that. Chris?
And St. Bernard.
St. Bernard. Oh, he said a German Shepherd.
You wanted a German Shepherd for so long.
I have never wanted a German Shepherd there.
Couples, thank you very much for your answers. 10-point question to next. We'll be right back with just the wives to see how well they predict what their husbands will say on the Newlywed Game in just a moment. But first, flashes of Victory Garden. Here's Johnny Dickens with gifts for today's Newlywed. Farmer John?
Very funny, Bob. And today's Newlywed wives will be very happy with their Regal Mardi Gras cookware that pairs beauty and utility in avocado-accented ceramic clad aluminum with super hard Teflon 2 to add a regal look to any kitchen. And also for them, here's America's famous town and country tableware by Washington Forge with beautiful fleetwood handles and mirror-bright stainless steel. They're dishwasher safe. The husbands will be right in the swing in their Harbor Master raincoat. This anywhere coat is stain and water repellent and features a zip-out lining in smart new shades. They're just right from Harbor Master. Today's second place winning couple will receive Noritake Progression China. This fine china can be used from freezer to oven to table. And it's dishwasher safe and so durable, guaranteed 2 years against breakage under normal household use. Now let's return to Bob Eubanks and those adorable Newlyweds.
Hey, John, thank you very much. All right, girls, your husbands have been secluded off stage, and now it's your turn to predict how they will answer these 10-point questions. So here we go with question number one for 10 points. Girls, which of the following will your husband say he likes best? A diaper, a bib, or a pacifier? Which does he like best, Peggy?
A pacifier. He has one.
He has a pacifier?
Yeah.
No
he
kidding.
He may buy one. Okay.
All right. Chris?
I'd have to go with pacifier. He'd love me to have one all the time. Keep my mouth shut.
Oh. Candy?
I'd have to say a pacifier, too. Something to keep me occupied, so I'd leave him alone once in a while.
Fine. Sharon, which of the following will your husband say he likes best, a diaper, a bib, or a pacifier?
I'd say a bib because he's a flub.
Next question, girls. Who will your husband say is the straightest shooter he knows? If it's a friend, first name only, please. Chris?
Gary.
Gary.
It must be Gary. He's a real straight shooter.
Fine. Candy?
Does it have to be a relative or not? Can't be a relative?
Straightest shooter he knows. If it's a friend, first name only, please.
John.
John. Sharon?
I would say Art.
Art. Peggy?
Steve McQueen.
Steve McQueen?
Yeah, he likes him, and I can't think of anybody else.
All right. Here's the last of our 10-point questions. Girls, what will your husband say is his least favorite thing to see after 6 p.m.? And be specific, please. His least favorite thing to see, Candy, after 6 p.m.?
Oh. Anything that would have to do with his job.
What would it be?
You want a telephone.
Telephone.
To have to see a telephone because he talks on it all day long.
Okay, Sharon?
I would say, from driving home for such a long distance, I would say a car.
A car, Peggy?
My next door neighbor. He doesn't like her.
Next door neighbor. Good. Chris?
Me, because he studies every night. And he's just
his least favorite thing to see after 6 p.m. is you.
I'm supposed to disappear.
I see. Here's a 25-point bonus question. Girls, will your husband say there is or is not a toothbrush in your home with a rubber gum massager on the end of it? Is there not, Sharon?
I would say is not.
There is not. Peggy?
There is not.
Is not. Chris?
Isn't.
Isn't. Candy?
There isn't, because every time we get one, he pulls it out.
Oh.
He doesn't like them.
No. Ladies, thank you very much for your answers. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game in just a moment. But first, it's a beautiful bride and a happy wedding couple named Larry and Candy Thomas.
The flavor of steak. Don't buy Heinz 57 sauce. You'd only be wasting your money. But if you want something that finishes the job salt and pepper starts, try 57 sauce. It respects a good cut of meat. Remember, Heinz 57 doesn't hide the flavor of meat. Oh no, we think it's the only sauce that finishes the job salt and pepper starts.
Now, gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. And remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. And here's question number one. For 10 points, gentlemen, which of the following do you like best? A bib, a diaper, or a pacifier? Which do you like best, Elton?
I think I'd say a bib.
A bib? Okay.
I have trouble once in a while. I think I need that more than anything.
I'm sorry. Chris says, you like a pacifier best?
To keep me quiet, you know.
Oh, well, that's not a bad idea.
John?
I'll say a pacifier.
Pacifier. So you predict you'll say a pacifier. That's right. You got a point. John? Why do you have a pacifier?
Well, stop it from biting on my fingernails, I guess.
When do you use a pacifier?
Oh, I'm watching TV. Break
Rick?
Your neck.
Rick?
The only one in our family who needs a bib is her, so I'm not, because she's kind of sloppy when she eats sometimes. And we don't have any children.
What is your answer, please?
Oh, my answer?
Yeah.
I would take a pacifier.
A pacifier. She said you'd take a bib.
Bib, beautiful.
You spill more food than I do.
You're the slob.
She said you're a real slob.
You are. You're not so unneat.
That is not true.
Oh. Larry?
I would have to say a bib. I don't see any reason why I need a pacifier or a diaper.
You better say. Okay. Candy said, you'd like the card, please. A pacifier.
A pacifier? What? What do I want one for?
I'm going to give you one now.
No,
You should have got that one, at least.
I eat, and it doesn't quite reach my mouth sometimes. So it would have to be a bit.
I'm the one that's messy. Remember, every time we have spaghetti all over, every time we have chilblains all over.
Well, the question
is... never a spot. Never a spot.
He's wrong.
This is fun, isn't it? Next question, gentlemen. Answers. Who's the straightest shooter you know? And if it's a friend, first name only, please. Straightest shooter you know. John?
Straightest shooter. Me.
No, I can't accept you.
You can't accept that, huh? Don.
Don, all right. Peggy said the straightest shooter you know is Steve McQueen.
Don.
Don. The cop,
oh,
you know?
Oh, yeah.
Dumb. Well, she's got a friend. It's just, a friend whose husband's a cop, you know, and I figured, well,
sure.
He shoots, you know.
Right. Rick?
I have a friend of mine that collects guns, and I think he would be the one. His name is Art.
Art. Your wife said Art. That's right.
Hey!
Larry, who's the straightest shooter you know?
I don't know too many straight shooters. I would have to say John Wayne.
John Wayne.
Is that...
John, okay.
Hey. You must know he's my favorite cowboy.
All right. Elvin, who's the straightest shooter you know?
Well, I can't say that I know very many straight shooters either, so... have to go with somebody famous, and John Wayne's about as straight as anybody.
I guess so. Chris predicted you would say Gary.
There he is.
Oh, my God.
Shoots what?
Oh, anything. He does all that kind of stuff. He does. He's our landlord, and he's quite not, you know, he's not like a landlord. And he'd do something like that. Shoot us.
Anything.
Oh. Here's the last of our 10-point questions. Gentlemen, what is your least favorite thing to see after 6 p.m.? And be specific. Your least favorite thing to see, Rick, after 6 p.m.
The least favorite thing to see after 6 p.m.?
Right.
Well, sometimes I don't get home that late or that early, but I don't know. I would say the news.
The news, all right. Sharon, pretty would say a car.
Car, you know, driving home. You don't like traffic.
When I make it home, I don't like to see the news because the traffic is very bad.
Okay, Larry, your least favorite thing to see after 6 p.m., be specific.
Well, if it's a TV program, I would have to say the news because I'm always watching TV.
Candy said your least favorite thing to see is a telephone.
We don't have a telephone.
You talk. Look, you talk on the telephone 8 hours a day. You say you hate it. That's why you won't even let us have one. And you tell me it's TV. What are you doing?
Well, I don't have a telephone. What do you mean?
You're not going to get one now.
We got one, but it doesn't work.
Your telephone doesn't work?
Just sit there.
It's not connected. Because he talks on the phone all day. He doesn't want to talk when he gets home, so we don't have a phone.
Yeah. You know, I get one now.
Who wins the arguments in your house?
I do.
You do not, all of them. Remember, it was half and half.
Quiet.
Well, I win half.
Which half do you win?
The best.
Oh. Eldon?
Well, I think my least favorite thing after 6 o'clock... would be the dishes.
The dishes.
All the time, but I hate
She said your least favorite thing to see after 6 p.m. is her.
Didn't you say that? Oh. Yeah, because you always have to stay in there.
That's what I come home for. And that's all the time I come home.
No, he sends me to the neighbor's house because he has to study. He has to, or else he leaves.
Oh,
that's not true.
John?
I'll say the kids because I'm always watching TV and I hate the kids bothering me when I'm watching TV after 6 o'clock.
Oh. Thank you for if you said least favorite thing is the next door neighbor.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true. Well, thank you very much for your answers. We'll be back with a big 25-point bonus question to see which couple will win their grand prize in just a moment.
Now that women have a diet good tasting enough to stay on, the men are reacting. They're leaving for the office later. They're coming home from the office earlier. Some are showing up for lunch. Others have even given up Tuesday night bowling. Slender from Carnation. 225 good-tasting calories mixed with milk. Good work, girls.
What's your cat? Persian? Calico? Or Siamese? You name it. Frisky's Buffet Cat Food will win her over. Beautiful, natural flavor with nothing added to spoil the taste. 12 beautiful buffet varieties with seafoods, poultry, liver, even giblets. No cat ever walked away from Frisky's buffet. Beautiful.
All right, gentlemen, here it is, your big 25-point bonus question for 25 points. Gentlemen, is there, or is there not, a toothbrush in your home with a rubber gum massager on the end of it? Let's go first to couple number two, Eldon and Chris, with zero. Eldon, if you get it right, you'll be in first place. Miss it, and you'll stay in last place.
Well, I've got to know this one. That's no. There is no.
No, there is not. Chris said there is not. That's right. You're in first place. Couple number three, John and Peggy, you have 10, 25, and give you 35. John, get it right, and you'll take over the lead. If you miss it, last place is yours.
The answer's got to be no, because she's always telling me we need one
no.
with
no. No, there is not. That's right. Okay. Couple number one, Larry and Candy Thomas with 15, 25, and give you 40. Larry, take over the lead with the correct answer. Miss it, and you'll be tied for last place.
That's real easy, because mine has a rubber tip at the end.
It has
we
a rubber
three.
Tip.
I don't know who's got one for. We got three of them, and mine has a rubber tip.
It does. All it right, does. Candy said that there is not. No.
What even? Mine has a rubber tip at the bottom.
I've never seen it.
Well, I'll show you when we get home.
I've never seen it.
You're going to see it.
I don't use yours.
But it's sitting there in the woods.
I've never seen it.
You ding-a-ling.
Calling me now.
Who's winning this one?
She lost because she got it wrong.
Oh.
She'll find out.
Couple number four. Rick and Sharon with 15, 25, and give you 40. Rick?
This had better be right. We buy them with them, but she pulls them off. There is not.
There is not. She said there is not. That's it. Rick and Sharon, you're our grand prize winner today.
Yes, Sharon and Rick, for each of you, a matching his and hers Yamaha sport cycle. For her, the Yamaha Newport Electra 50, featuring the popular Sept through frame, automatic clutch, three-speed transmission, plus waterproof and dustproof brakes. You get 200 miles per gallon with a Newport 50. And for him, it's the famous Yamaha Rotary Jet 100, with big bike styling at a cruising speed of 65 miles per hour. All yours from many happy hours is today's grand prize winners of the Newlywed Game.
Rick and Sharon, congratulations for being our winners today on the Newlywed Game. Remember to stay tuned for Jim Lang, the main game, Bob Eubank saying thank you, and bye for now.